Good day, folks. Today, I will be sharing my collection of Dirk Nowitzki's autographed cards and memorabilia, which showcases how his autograph has evolved over the years. I hope that fellow collectors would find this video helpful in their own hunts for Dirk autographs. First is a signed photo of young Dirk in a Würzburg X-Rays uniform. It was taken at a Division II German League game. The photograph was developed in November of 1997. Judging by his fresh buzz cut, this would have been taken around September 1997, shortly after he joined the Bundeswehr for his compulsory military service. He signed his full name on the photo, which makes it really special. My research shows that he signed this way probably until October of 1998, and shortened it thereafter. He must have gotten more autograph requests after being drafted to the NBA, so it would have been more practical to shorten it. By the time he arrived in the States in January 1999, his autographs were already shortened. Next up is Dirk's first autographed German national team card. These were given out to fans on national team tours and games during their European Championship campaigns on November to December of 1998. And these ones on June to July of 1999. I submitted 3 copies of these to Beckett, with this sample returning inconclusive, which may be because it looks a bit different from the rest of his early career autographs. It bears some resemblance to the autograph I showed earlier, which makes me think that this could be a transitional autograph to his shorter form. Note that he was still signing his full signature by October of 1998, and these cards were given away around November of 1998. Next up is Dirk's Würzburg X-Rays autographed card. These were given out to fans during X-Rays games in their 1998-99 Division 1 campaign. Here we see his early career autograph form take shape after transitioning from his full signature, and a fantastic photo of him making a jump shot over defender. Dirk's early career autograph had a rare variant where he inscribed 41 over the letters OW. This would be the first known instance of him adding his jersey number to his autograph. I was lucky to find 2 samples of this variant. This large one on an index card, and this one on his Skybox Molten Metal rookie card. Although you can find many of Dirk's signed rookie cards on marketplaces these days, almost all of them have his modern autograph form, like this one. Since he didn't have any pack-pulled rookie year autograph cards, my sample would be the closest one you could get to a period correct piece. Next up, we've got an autographed 4x6 card that were given away at Nike basketball promotional events in Germany, right after Dirk's rookie season. We can see him rocking a pair of 1998 Nike Air Breakdown Uptempos, which we can find him wearing on most of his rookie year cards and photos. These were also the ones he wore during his very first NBA regular season game. Dirk signed with Nike Germany before playing in the NBA and has been an endorser of the brand ever since. Dirk's first pack-pulled autographed card is his Sign of the Times insert from 1999-2000 SB Authentic, circulated during his second year in the league. I love that they also happen to use blue ink to sign these. However, they are prone to fading upon heavy UV exposure. If you find any of these with faint black ink, it is most likely faded. Here we have one of Dirk's most interesting and best-looking autographed cards in my opinion. His Autographics On Location insert from 2001 Fleer Futures. It's got an actual postage stamp and a postmark from the US Postal Service commemorating the date and the location of the signing session. The postcode is 75260, which refers to the main post office in Dallas. It was a couple of miles away from the old Reunion Arena, where Dirk most likely signed it. It was very fortunate that he signed these cards at home court, as other players in the set, like Vince Carter, signed them while on the road. Another offering from Fleer was Dirk's Autographics SSD, or Signed Sealed Delivered, from 2001 Fleer Authority. These actually came out of packs already graded, Fleer embossed some of its regular autographics cards with stamps of authority and sent them to Beckett for grading. They were then inserted into Fleer authority boxes along with graded 1-card packs and ungraded 5-card packs. Beckett was tougher back in the day, and most of these cards had disappointing grades. Almost 70% of Dirk SSDs were graded 8 below. Imagine getting that grade for a card that's supposed to be fresh out of the pack. Indeed, many of them were eventually cracked out of the slabs. Next up is another Sign of the Times insert from 2001 SP Authentic. This card was redemption only, meaning they were likely released much later than the previous Fleer cards. Some of these Sign of the Times cards were still signed with his early career form, while others had 41 added at the end. Sometime between 2001 to 2002, Dirk permanently incorporated 41 into his autographs. After this release, it is widely speculated that Dirk didn't sign any more pack pulled autographs until Panini arrived in 2009. Although these cards are not rare by today's standards, the fact that he only used his early career form for 2 years makes them scarce and, in my opinion, highly undervalued. When he returned to signing cards in 2009, he was already using the modern form that we see today. Up next is another Nike basketball autographed card, which was signed for fans at Nike Germany promotional events in 2003. It features a cool comic book rendition of Dirk driving the ball, evocative of his early Kaboom cards. Prominently displayed are one of the shoes he wore during the 2002-2003 season, the 2002 Nike Air Max Chosen. Although he took a break from signing licensed autographs from 2001 to 2009, he still generously signed autographs for fans in person and through the mail. This card features the next iteration of Dirk's autograph, which is a noticeable departure from his early career form. His classic autograph is shortened, with the addition of a loop above the letter succeeding N, and a sharp Z-like tail below. His jersey number is usually inscribed in the gap between the loop and the tail. This closely resembles the autograph form he uses nowadays. Here's another national team card, signed for fans during the 2011 Eurobasket campaign in Lithuania. Despite the exhausting journey to win the NBA championship that year, Dirk still committed to suiting up for the German national team. What's interesting about the autograph on this card is that instead of his usual 41 jersey number inscription, he flipped it back to 14, which was his jersey number when he was still with the national team and with the Würzburg X-Rays. He was the first German basketball player to have his national team jersey number retired. Dirk rarely signed like this, as he still inscribed 41 on most of his national team autograph cards that I've seen. It makes this piece quite scarce and special. The last three pieces I'm sharing have his modern autograph form, which were all signed during his visit here in Australia on January 2023. First is a signed jersey that was included in the meet and greet package I got during Dirk's speaking event in Melbourne. Next up is one of my most treasured pieces, a custom card I designed for him as a gift, which he actually signed in front of me. I waited 2 decades to finally meet him, and it was such a privilege to experience a personal signing. It is something I will never ever forget. The last one is from the collaboration project of Dirk and renowned Australian artist Tyson Beck, a dual autograph of the player and the artist on a card commemorating the 2011 NBA championship. He also signed this during the same visit in January. I've put the link below of that signing session with Tyson Beck. That's it, friends. I hope that I was able to contribute to the knowledge base of the different forms Dirk's autographs took over the years, and I hope that fellow collectors find my research useful in their respective hunts or purchases. Please like and subscribe, and I hope to see you soon.